What's going on, guys? We have our first big trade of the trade deadline season. New Jersey trading both Cal Palmieri and Travis Zajac to New York Islanders in exchange for AJ Greer, Mason Joss, a 2021 first-round pick, and a conditional fourth-round pick that could become a third-rounder if the Islanders make it to the Stanley Cup Final in this year's playoffs. So I think like this is going to be the first domino to fall. At least I hope it is, as I want to see some more trades here leading up to the deadline next Monday. So we got like, what, 5 days left. Now, both these guys were traded from the Devils at 50% retained. Surprisingly, actually, the Islanders still have like $3.5 million, I think. I saw Cap Friendly saying using LTIR, so they could potentially not be done. They could maybe make another move here. Now, both Palmieri and Zajac were on expiring contracts, so a good chance one, if not both of them, would have walked this summer in free agency. Also, they're veterans, so, you know, New Jersey, again, looks to be in a rebuild. They probably want to have a chance to win somewhere. I feel like they have a pretty good chance with the New York Islanders. I mean, they already look like a solid team in that Eastern Division. Adding these two guys definitely going to help them load up. Palmieri is going to fit in the top six, probably. Worst case is a third liner, probably play third line with Pageau. Travis Zajac, I feel a third liner as well. Maybe he's a fourth line center. Makes the best fourth line in hockey even better. I really like the fact they got both Palmieri and Zajac in this trade, though, as if you would have told me they traded a first rounder for Palmieri, I would have thought, you know, makes sense. But the fact they got Zajac too just adds a bit more depth, I think, to the bottom six, which obviously we know is very important in these playoffs. So I'm trying to find these two guys here, and I am struggling. Wow, so that's why Kyle Palmieri there has barely any value. 29 years old, so he's actually not that old. For some reason, I thought he was early 30s. 82 overall, making 4.6 for one more year. So they traded him with Travis Zajac. Zajac's on a pretty big contract. 35 years old. He's definitely got, you know, a few years left in him. 80 overall. He's a pretty good face-off, man. You guys will see that in-game. 91 face-offs. You know, pretty good defensive stats as well, I think. You know, he'll fit in nicely in that bottom six for the Islanders. So both these guys together, they give a first-round pick. Now, the thing with the first-round pick is it's really not that big of a deal this year. I saw an article saying how a lot of executives think first-round picks have the least amount of value they've had in, like, 10 years this season. As not only is this a lower-end draft class, but due to all the lockdowns and things like that, a lot of the scouting this year has actually been done just watching games online opposed to in-person. So you basically aren't getting as good of a feel for these players, not as accurate of reading on their talents. So I feel like taking all that into consideration, giving up a first-round pick for these guys, it really isn't that bad of a trade at all. Also, too, like I said, the Islanders are going for it. So the two guys in this trade, AJ Greer here, he's a pretty good AHL player. I'm not sure if he'll ever be an NHL player though. You can see in game, 23 years old, 74 overall, medium top nine. I look at his full career stats here. 1920, 32 points, 47 games in the AHL. The year before that, 44 and 54. So that's not too bad. And then Mason Joss here, I accidentally skipped. He's 26, 68 overall with AHL potential. He's an AHL player. He's basically just an add-on for the roster spot. Wow. So I think we know what's gonna happen with this trading game. The Islanders' first round pick is worth quite a bit, as EA just disrespects them, never gives them the credit they deserve. Ryan Pollock, Adam Pellick, one of the best D pairs in the NHL. I think they're both like 84s. You probably make the argument they should both be 86, even 87s. And just recently, they actually upgraded Pellick from like, what, a 78 to an 82, and then 82 to 84. The 78 to start of the year, like for the game that is, was absolutely disrespectful. The fourth round pick here, like I said, is going to be 2022, could turn into a third rounder. If it does turn into a third rounder, then they can make it a 2023 third rounder. The first round pick already has so much value though, so we'll just say it's a fourth rounder. Well, so they do not make the cup final. New York Islanders actually be over the league maximum salary cap, $4.5 million over there. You can see these two guys even at 50%. I mean, I probably don't have to click, you know, make the trade go through, whatever. There's just no way it's going to happen. I wonder, even if we take back Andrew Ladd's salary, that'll actually make it go through. I feel like they're still going to say no to this one. Yeah, trade rejected. So even taking back the cap dump that is Andrew Ladd, they're not down for this, which I kind of expected. So in game, EA feels like the Islanders got fleeced here. But like I said, in real life, I think it was a pretty fair trade. So after putting the trade through, guys, look at the Devils' lines here. And it is tough. They got Gustav on that first line. They actually just put on waivers. Hischier has been injured for a while. Jesper Bratt's a good player. Andreas Janssen, Hughes, Zacha, Wood, McLeod, Bastion, Boqvist, Merkley, who they also just put on waivers, and Kukkonen. I mean, there's really not a lot of star power here. Obviously, Hischier and Hughes, both first overall picks. But unfortunately for the Devils, I would say they're both looking like lower end first overall picks. These guys definitely, I think, need to take a next step if they're to carry the Devils to be a Stanley Cup champion. I feel like right now, I don't see either of these guys being a player that can kind of carry a team on their back to a Stanley Cup. So they'll either have to get some really nice supporting pieces, or like I said, take that next step. I'm actually looking at their lines online. It's even worse somehow. Like some of these guys, I follow the NHL pretty religiously. Igor Sharangovich, I've seen his name popping around, but he's not a first line player. Mikhail Maltsev, Tyson Thompson, they got Will Butcher as a forward. It's just rough to look at. So defensively here is actually not that bad. The oldest defenseman they have is PK Subban, he's 31. Obviously, PK has kind of been on decline the past couple years, has that big contract, but he's still PK Subban. There's definitely worse parts of this team. Ryan Murray's 26, Vatanen's 29, Severson 26, Ty Smith's 20, looks really good. Will Butcher 25. I think Ty Smith should probably be like an 82, honestly, in this game. So I think defensively, they're pretty young. That's not a terrible thing. Mackenzie Blackwood looks like a legit starting goalie. The thing with them is they just have really no star power. I think, you know, Hischier is their best player right now. After that, you know, they have Hughes, who, like I said, he's got to, you know, up his game. The rest of that forward group is pretty terrible. So it'll be interesting to see what they do this summer. I think I picked the Devils actually to be the last place team in the NHL this year. I was wrong with that pick. It looks like that's pretty much going to be a guarantee to the Buffalo Sabres. But after trading away Palmieri and Zajac and looking at the lines they currently have, I don't think they're any better than Buffalo on paper. So I'll be very interested to see how they play the last, you know, 20 games here. And now trying this trade from the Islanders' perspective. As you can see, Palmieri's actually not on the block for the Devils, which is a little interesting. Travis Zajac, I know he didn't have too much value at all. Also not on the block there, which I'm honestly kind of surprised by, seeing as they are a seller. I feel like they would definitely want to move a guy, especially like Zajac, big contract, 35 years old. So we're going to retain 50% on both of them. I think I actually forgot to show you guys their actual NHL stats, so I'll do that quick. And while I'm doing the 50% here, one thing I noticed on Twitter, someone said because they're being traded from New Jersey to New York, they can actually hypothetically play right away. I'm sure they'll probably have to go through like some sort of test or whatever, but unlike a lot of guys who got traded, who had to wait like 2 weeks, like say Dubois, I think, these guys can pretty much jump into the team immediately. So I think it gives even more value to the trade for the Islanders as they get these guys even sooner, help them win even more games, hopefully. So Palmieri there, you can see pretty consistently like a 50-point guy, if not 50. He's in the high 40s over the past 5 seasons. So I'm surprised his value is so low. 82 overall, he should probably be like an 83. Travis Zajac, not quite the same player he used to be. Used to be, you know, more of a 50-point guy, 67, might be his career high there. It's been a while since then. I had 50, 13, 14, but recently, 18, 19, 46 was his best, 25 this year, 26 the time before that in 63 games. He's like a 30-point guy, pretty smart defensively, good in the faceoffs. Again, you can see we can't make this trade. So the reason the Islanders have so much cap space is that Anders Lee's on LTIR right now, making $7 million. Then we have some other guys, I think, on LTIR too that aren't on LTIR in-game, but Lee's the big one there. So, again, I'm going to add Andrew Lowe to this trade as he kind of just evens it out, I think, honestly. So, there we go. The trade value is still overwhelmingly on our side. I know for sure they're going to say yes. So, I wonder, instead of a 2021 first-rounder, because it has way too much value, because we know, like, Islanders right now, I think, are tied for first in the East with the Capitals. What if we gave up a... I'm trying to get a first rounder that doesn't have a ton of value. Let's try a 2022 second rounder instead here. I feel like the value is pretty close to what a first rounder would be if at the deadline you were winning the division. They kind of tell the other team it's probably going to be a late first round pick, which of course is the case in real life. You can see they do want the second still. I forgot to mention too, with the last trade, the Islanders of course did want both Palmieri and Zajac, which is pretty cool. Now the value is still on our side. So if this goes through, obviously it would go through with the first rounder. So let's see what Lou Lamoriello and the Devils say to this one. Trade rejected. Interesting. Okay, interesting. With the first rounder, though, in 2021, I feel like it's almost a lock, unless it's just Andrew Ladd that's not going to get this to go through. Wow, yes. Or no, it's actually the salary. They don't retain 50%, which, I mean, look at the value difference there. It's on medium difficulty. It's 50%, but come on. Instead of using Andrew Ladd for the salary to work out, I'm going to try using Leo Komarov there. Hopefully, he doesn't have as much negative value. We'll see if they say yes to this. Trade is still rejected. Are you kidding me? That's very interesting. Okay. So, I put Ladd back in the trade, but I now have them both at 25%. This would be weird if they say no to this one. Wow. So, they're just unwilling to retain the salary, which makes no sense. 1 year left, whether it's the beginning of the season or not. They're a seller. They know they're probably going to trade these guys anyways. But yeah, in-game, both sides reject. So, I thought originally... EA thought, you know, Devils fleece the Islanders here, but because they're still rejecting with those two at 50%, technically means they think it's a fair trade for both sides, but I feel like really just the AI not understanding the true value of salary retention. So after putting the trade through, guys, here's an updated look at the Islanders lines. This is just kind of my best guess of what they're going to go with. First line here, I have Cal Palmieri playing with Barzal and Eberle. I feel like if they're giving up a first round pick for Palmieri, they're definitely going to put him in a top six role. Online right now, it shows Komarov was playing first line with Barzal and Eberle. That's going to change for sure. So I think Palmieri can fit in there. First line, left wing. Second line looked good to me. Beauvillier, Nelson, Bailey. Third line have been Wallstrom, Pageau, Cizikas. And then fourth line here is now Komarov, Zajac, and Clutterbuck. I feel like Zajac's probably more of a natural center than Cizikas. Cizikas, you can move up to that third line, but the third line left wing is probably the biggest question mark for me with the new roster. Defensively, no changes. Pelech, Pollock, Mayfield, Letty, Green, Dobson. I did forget to mention, though, the Devils actually now have the Islanders' first and second round picks in this year's draft, as the Islanders actually traded their second round pick in this year's draft at last year's deadline for Andy Green. So I'm sure the Devils are going to be hoping the Islanders don't do too well. That way, both the first and the second are a little bit higher up in the draft. Of course, goaltending, they have Varlamov, who's looked very, very good this year. Sorokin's also looked solid too. Bit of a shaky first couple games for him, and since then, been pretty much lights out. So, even without Anders Lee there on the team, I think this Islanders team is pretty solid. I feel like they're showing that in the standings. I'll give you guys a quick look here. Palmieri as an Islander. I guess I could show you Zajac too, because Zajac's never not been a Devil. So Cal Palmieri here, I feel like he's going to probably look, yeah, looks pretty good there as an Islander. Looks kind of like Nick Leddy, I'm not going to lie, with the beard. We'll take a look at Zajac as well on this Islanders team. Honestly, guys, I think, like I said, a good trade for both teams. Really, I don't see a winner. I think, you know, the Islanders got some good depth. Palmieri should fit in the top six. Zajac, bottom six. First rounder this year is not really worth too much. The Devils trade two guys who might have walked in free agency. I heard that they were trying to sign Palmieri, so the fact they traded him tells me he's probably not going to re-sign anyways. Zajac there as an Islander. So, like I said, good trade for both teams. Islanders definitely should be tough competition for whatever team matches up with them in the playoffs this year. But that's gonna be it for this video, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, leave the thumbs up. Let me know in the comment section which team you think won the trade. Also, guys, if you haven't subscribed yet, hit that subscribe button. And as always, thanks so much for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.